Welcome back. Last video, we talked about unified shared memory. The fact that a programmer can virtually see one unified memory space across a host and other devices like GPU or FPGA makes memory accesses much easier. And it is great that SYCL is executing kernels asynchronously and in a non-blocking manner. But it also means that race conditions are possible. And you, as a programmer, has to make sure data coherency is kept. SYCL has several ways to control such execution dependencies. Let me show you in a minute. A simple example and all the code snippet could be found in the video description. So I have here a queue attached to my GPU and data defined as unified shared memory is an array of size n filled with ones. And I'm using malloc shared, so the memory is shared between the host and the device mapped to this queue, not any device. And now, kernel A is filling all the entries of data with 2. This kernel uses parallel 4, so basically every iteration, every work item is independent. It will be launched and executed asynchronously on the device, on the GPU in this case, and it is not blocking, so the host will continue to work. The host will continue to kernel B. Here, I'm updating each of the entries to be 3. And again, N work items will be launched on the GPU. And kernel C is updating data to 4. All of these kernels will be running asynchronously and will compete for the data. There's no guarantee what will be the execution order, and hence, no way to know the final results as they could be indeterminate. We must, of course, free up the data at the end of the program. But as it is written here, the host might free up the data while the work items have not yet finished and are still working on the GPU. So be careful, this is a race condition. So a barrier before we free up the data is required. We can add a wait command separately, like I did here, or at the end of the last kernel. But what about the data races? This code is far from being thread safe. One way is to add a barrier to each of the kernels. So we can add wait commands to each of the kernels, and now we can make sure that a kernel will be launched only after the previous one has finished all of its work items. This will block or synchronize the execution on the host. A different way is to use an in-order queue. A wait command will sync the execution on the host. An in-order queue does not require the host interaction, but the device will manage the queue work items executions in order. Might be more efficient. So the device will make sure that the kernels are performed internally on the device in order. Getting the data back to the host requires another synchronization on the host to make sure we do not print or free the data before all the kernels completed. Moving to in-order execution of the kernels might slow down the execution sometimes without a real need. So there is a more precise and elegant way to define kernels' dependencies to each other. I'll better just show it up by an example. Again, I have a queue to the GPU and array of data. I define here a SYCL event and I call it K1, kernel 1, and another event which I call K2, and another one K3. And I can define that K2 event is dependent on K1 event, and K3 is dependent on K2, and so on, for any flow graph as complex as could be. So now the graph can be executed asynchronously in a non-blocking manner, unless I define the dependency. Please note that at the end, I'm not waiting for a queue, but I'm waiting on an event. Here, waiting on event K3. All of these synchronization examples are basically doing the same thing and should give similar performance. Feel free to try them all out and compare. And look for the link to the code below. And yes, lots of resources to learn from, books, webinars, tutorials. Here are some links. Enjoy. Thank you.